We're here with the brand new iPhone 10. We've just picked it up. Max is very, very excited. Look at him. And we're going to unbox it and play around with it and give it a bit of a hands-on review. Max, there you go. Do the honors.
Okay. Let's get it. There's a little pull tab here.
Yep, no need for scissors there. So what's the difference, Max, between this and, let's say, the iPhone 8?
So whereas the iPhone 8 kind of continued that design that you've seen with the iPhone 6 and iPhone 7, this kind of really goes with a much more modern look. So you've got that screen that kind of goes edge to edge. You've got the notch, very controversial.
The monobrow, as some people call it.
And it also has a larger screen, but in a smaller footprint. So if you found the Plus too big, but you wanted big screen, then this is kind of just a little bit bigger than the iPhone 8, but with a screen size.
Peel that. Oh, that's lovely. That's just...
They don't quite make the sounds peeling.
They used to do. That's nice. So obviously you got the iPhone 10 in the box, obviously.
It's really nice, isn't it?
It's quite dense.
It does feel more substantial than the iPhone 8, doesn't it? And it's a bit...
Well, you've got the new stainless steel
rim. It's a bit shinier, yeah, exactly. It feels like a really, really solid device.
I mean, this is a $1,000
phone, so... Fair enough. I mean, you kind of want that, don't you? The buttons are pretty similar to what you would expect from an iPhone. That's quite a large power button there. I suppose it's trying to make up for the lack of home button, because there is no home button now. It's just all screen.
It's all screen.
I mean, do you think that's going to be a problem?
I think once you get used to the gestures, so it's a very gesture-based interface now, there's swipes and stuff to get around. But obviously the home button has been on every single iPhone so far for 10 years. So, and I instinctively click that home button, you know, it's on the desk. You click that home button and it feels familiar.
It's that thing, isn't it, where if anything goes wrong, if you're in an app and you're not quite sure what to do or whatever, you just press that home button, you're back in safe territory, you're back in your home screen.
That being there, I think, you know, could take a bit of getting used to. Let's have a look what else is in the box. It looks like exactly the same as you get with those phones. Power brick. The headphones.
And the adapter.
Dongle. Would have been nice if they include some AirPods.
I think for £1,000, I'd like to have some AirPods with that.
It would have been nice if they were maybe a black cable or something different. Yeah.
I mean, the box is embossed, which is nice.
Yes. You can sort of feel the box. It's a little touchy.
But yeah, I mean, it just... feels like you know, it's very similar to buying an iPhone SE, which is £700 cheaper, which is a bit of a shame. But yeah, then the device is very nice. I mean, just to show how much bigger the Plus is.
So you got the Plus
just,
there, haven't you?
I've got the Plus here, and it just goes to show. I mean, it if you kind of stack it up like that, and you can see it's both the height and the width are significantly smaller, and yet the screen isn't that much, like in terms of the screen area, it's not that much smaller, is it?
So the screen on the X is, the 10 is 5.8 inches, 5.5 inch on there, but not really giving the whole story because obviously it's a lot, the iPhone 8 Plus is kind of wider.
You
still get more screen real estate on the Plus, but obviously it's a lot bigger phone. It'll be interesting to see when you use it sort of. If it's more of a Plus experience or more of a 8 experience in apps and stuff. So here's the 8.
I mean, what's the difference there between, you know, the Plus phone and the non-Plus phone? There are some features.
So there are a lot of software tweaks. So in the email app, for instance, if you tilt the phone landscape, you'll get 2 pane views.
Okay.
And same in Safari, you'll get tab browsing along the top, kind of like you do on the iPad. You don't get that on the 8. I don't believe you get that on the 10 either. So I think in software terms, the 10 works more like the 8 than the Plus.
Okay.
Do you get what I mean?
Yeah. There's no home button, obviously, as we talked about, which means there's no Touch ID either.
Yeah.
So what have Apple done about that?
So no fingerprint sensor at all. I mean, some people thought they were going to put it on the back, though instead you've got this new thing called Face ID. So this sort of all lives in the notch up here. There's a depth sensor, there's a infrared camera, there's a dot camera, and there's the 7-megapixel camera as well. So these all work together to create a depth map of your face, and it's... Well, kind of works in a similar way to Touch ID. You just lift the phone up, it scans your face, and allegedly unlocks. I mean, will it be quick? You know, how accurate will it be in the dark? These are all questions that we'll have to answer before review.
Yeah, and I think generally, because it works reasonably well. I mean, it didn't work well when they announced it, did it? So there was a problem then, which was slightly embarrassing. But I think it's, you know, losing Touch ID, if Face ID works that well, won't be a big loss, as long as it unlocks very, very quickly.
But if it doesn't work, Because, I mean, Touch ID is reliably fantastic every time.
Yeah, it is.
If this even doesn't work one every five attempts...
Oh, God, yeah.
I think it will be...
It'll be a pain.
It'll be a pain.
I think, though, that what's interesting about it is that it's also a lot more secure than Touch ID. So, according to Apple, it's a 1 in a million potential match as opposed to 1 in 50,000 with Touch ID. So, that's a lot more secure. The problem being, if you're identical twins, it has been shown that it will unlock for your identical twins. So, if you've got
that
issue...
You've got an evil twin,
If you've got an evil twin, might have a little goatee beard, then just... Be aware of that, because you might. Yeah, it's quite a niche case, but yeah.
Also, the screen is different. So every iPhone so far has had an LCD display.
Yep.
This switches to OLED. Now, there's kind of been a bit of controversy about OLED recently with the Pixel 2 XL, which had a not very good LG-made OLED display. This has a Samsung display, just like the S8 and Note 8. Apple says they've done loads of stuff to it to kind of help those OLED issues of kind of bad viewing angles and.
Changing colours and things like that,
and stuff. But yeah, Apple said they've done a lot. It's got the same True Tone stuff, same haptic feedback, same 3D touch that you've been used to in an iPhone. But it's just higher res, sharper, should have better contrast, and it's HDR as well on Dolby Vision, so maybe it's from my channel. Should look really good.
It's about time, isn't it, as well, because it's been, the screens have improved, but in terms of the resolution, that hasn't really increased for quite a long time.
I mean, they've stuck at 1080p, 5.5-inch on the Plus.
Yeah.
Since the 6 Plus,
since the first one
years ago. Like the Plus, you've got the two 12-megapixel cameras on the back. The telephoto one is stabilized now.
Yes.
So you've got OIS. Battery life, so Apple's saying the 10 should last 2 hours longer than the iPhone 7.
I'm guessing that'll put it in the range of somewhere between the iPhone 7 and iPhone 7 Plus, but not quite.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think you're kind of looking 2 days. I mean, I tend to get a day and a half easily from the Plus.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
I think it's probably will be a charge every night device.
Yeah, I think so. But obviously it's got wireless charging now as
well. It's got wireless charging, but it's still slow wireless charging at the minute.
Yeah.
But you know, wireless charging is nice to have, obviously with the glass back.
Well, here it is. It's very, very nice. We're gonna be putting it through our review process right now. Max is gonna be reviewing it, and the full review will be coming up very soon.